Hey, welcome back to Who May Be a Leader. And the last time we left you, we was talking about how God helped us to relate to Him rightly and to relate to others into this world in several different ways. Number one, He helped us in having a relationship with Him through Christ. He helps us in the way we study the Word of God, and He helps us by paying attention and keeping our conscience clean, and He helps us through other people such as counselors and, you know, lay peoples and other people that God chooses to use us to impact our life. Now, we want to talk about what it takes to love unconditionally. Listen at this. Since we are loved by God unconditionally, we have the ability through His love to love unconditionally in whatever situation we find ourselves in. Man, I tell you one thing. I'm going to be honest with you. I ain't felt that in some situations that I was in. Maybe you have. Maybe I, but one of the things that I've learned, when I can't love that person, because God has called us to love our enemy, and some of us can love our enemy better than we can love our spouse, better than we can love our kids. Sometimes we just don't show grace to the people who we supposedly supposed to love. But God say we have the ability to love unconditionally in whatever situation we find ourselves in. Now, the thing about it is that when we can't do that, it's because we think we owed something. When we find ourselves in treacherous situations, bad situations, such as our marriages and, you know, wayward children and stuff like that, we ask them the question, why us and stuff like that. And of course, I would say, why not you? Christ suffered, not that we wouldn't suffer, but He suffered to show us how to suffer to the point of death. Now, I know you, a lot of people don't like hearing that because they say that's Christ and He was perfect and blah, blah, this, blah, blah, that. And so what I'm saying is that's true. He was perfect, but He was the prime example to help us to be able to walk this walk. And God is saying that we have the ability to learn unconditionally. Now, the other thing is, too, is that we expect for a person to do the right thing. And I get you on that, because some of the thing, I have this conversation with my wife, I have it with Angela a lot of times about our expectation of people. And sometimes our expectation is way higher than God. And that's why it's hard for us to show any kind of grace or mercy, because we expect so much out of people, but we don't want to give much ourselves. Because I believe that relationships today is everyone trying to see how much they can get away with. Everyone trying to see how much they can get away with not doing. Let me put that on there, not doing. But I want to share some things with you. Look at Romans chapter 5, verse 8, because one of the things that we sitting around waiting, we waiting for the other person to do something before we do anything. And let me read this to you. Romans chapter 5, verse 8. He said, but God, now listen at this, but God demonstrated His own love towards us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. See, we waiting for the other person to do something right for us to do what we're supposed to do. Now, this is what I always tell people that's in a marriage. Even though you're supposed to become one, you still judge individually. Listen to what I'm saying. You're supposed to become one, but you judge individually. Look at the garden. When God came back to the garden, He came looking for Adam. And man, I want to say that to you, because I realize that I'm the priest of my home, that I'm the headship. See, we want to be the headship when it's convenient for us. But when the times get tough and we got to lay down ourselves, then we don't want to be the leader anymore. And I'm telling you, it's a tough spot to be a leader. It ain't an easy thing, because everybody is looking towards you for what to do. And if you don't have the answers, then, you know, people going to perish. And what I mean by that is this. That's why you need to have understanding. First of all, you need to have the knowledge of God's word. Then you need to be able to understand what he's saying so you can have wisdom to walk it out and also show your family what it is. Because he said we have the ability to love unconditionally. But when we put ourselves in the way, when we think more highly of ourselves, when we think that we deserve something, when we think that we should be treated like this, it's going to be hard to love unconditionally. But God demonstrated his love towards us yet while we were still sinners. But you need to demonstrate your love towards whoever that person is that's showing you whatever they're showing you of being disrespected. But you need to demonstrate your love towards them yet while they were still treating you the way that they was treating you. But God demonstrated his love towards us yet while we were still sinners. Not only that, when you look at Galatians chapter 5, and you probably know where I'm going with this, Galatians chapter 5, because if you know Galatians, what it's saying, verse 22, but the fruit of the Spirit is what? Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness. And let's go on to verse 23. Gentleness, self-control, against such things there is no law. Against such things there is no law. God said that we have the ability when we allow the Spirit to take hold of us. Remember, he said if you walk in the Spirit, then you won't carry out the deeds of the flesh. A lot of us are professing Christian, calling ourselves Christian, going to church day after day, but we're not allowing the Spirit to take hold. Now, don't misunderstand me, because I'm not saying this like I got it perfect. I don't have it perfect, but I do understand how God have it, how he operate. And I understand that when I don't allow his Spirit to permeate in me, when I don't allow his Spirit to take over me, guess what? I'm going to do what I want to do. Because remember, I told you a long time ago, when you get up each day, it's two choices you're going to make, either to please you or please God. It's simple as that. It ain't no mystical about that. It's either to please you or please God. In Galatians, the fruit of the Spirit tells us what we need to do. And then the fact is that let's look at 1 John chapter 3. 1 John chapter 3, because God has some good things in his word. And if you're going to be a Christian, then by God, you ought to seek to live out your Christianity through the word of God. Chapter 3, verse 15 says, everyone who hates his brother is a murderer. And you know that no murderer has inner life abiding in him. We know love by this, that he laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our life for our brethren. But whoever has the world's good, listen at that, whoever has the world's good and see his brother in need, closes his heart against him, how does the love of God abide in him? And that's what you need to know, that the love of God ain't abiding in you if you can just walk by your spouse and know that they suffering. Now, they may not be suffering that they need some kind of material thing, but they may be suffering to where they need your encouragement. They may be suffering to where they need your love. They may be suffering to where they need you to comfort them. They may be suffering in that aspect. And God is saying that when you close your heart to that, because them that know and do not do is sinning. When you know that a person needs something from you and you just walk right on by, God is saying that it's sin in your heart. Because one of the things we know, God is love. Let's look at 1 John chapter 4. 1 John chapter 4, verse 7. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is from God, and everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. The one who does not love does not know God, for God is love. By this, the love of God was manifested in us, that God has sent his only begotten Son into the world so that we might live through him. In this, the love not that we love, but he loved us and sent his Son as a propitiation for our sin. God is calling us to be unconditional lovers, and that's what we need to be. And I want you to challenge yourself, that the person that may be getting at you the worst, I want you to just pour out that love on them and see what happens, and see, don't God change your heart and begin to change that person, because I believe a change bring a change. Hey, until we see you next time, may God bless you and keep you as our prayer. And remember, examine yourself so you can balance yourself. God bless you.